Welcome back to the KCRA 3 Experience. We got Cowpokes, Princess Brides, we got Spider-Man, we got Pirates. A lot of folks down here at the KCRA 3 Experience inside the Arden Fair Mall. It is our annual Halloween party. Mike Arquette getting the tight shot with his famous wide lens. Well, a massive pumpkin, the second largest in the world, actually, is adorning the famous Chelsea Market in New York today. The overgrown gourd was actually taken from a field in Iowa and turned into a work of art just in time for today's festivities. Michelle Franson with that story.
At a whopping 1,662 pounds, this pumpkin is center stage at New York's Chelsea Market. For Hugh McMahon, it is a piece of art just waiting to be carved.
It is a relaxing thing to do. I do enjoy the extra process of carving.
McMahon has been turning pumpkins into works of art for more than three decades, celebrating the season one slice at a time.
The idea is to do a real scary kind of sun face in dishonor of global warming.
McMahon's tools are simple. Sharp knives do the trick. The treat, a 3D spectacle that shines.
I love it.
Anywhere I love but home. It. You know, got to me. I like it. It's so big.
We want to take it home on the plane.
And for those who have yet to carve, McMahon has some tips.
So I like to clean out the pumpkin from underneath so you keep the shape of the stem. And I spray with lemon juice afterwards to preserve it. And you can refrigerate it too.
Good advice and huge inspiration to help you get carving.
Michelle Franzen, KCRA 3 reports.
All right, we are back out live here at the KCRA 3 Experience, some amazing creations, and look what else they carved. That's our stage manager, Ruben, and oddly enough, Ruben shows up to work more often than not looking like that anyway. Joining us today, Alan Silva, a professional pumpkin carver who is professionally carving a pumpkin right now. He's also a face painter, Dave's Pumpkin Patch of West Sacramento. Dave is here, who is the proprietor.
Yes,
Dave,
sir.
Nice to have you here. So tell me exactly, Alan, spin that around and tell me what you're working on right now.
Well, I'm trying to create a skull out of this pumpkin.
Okay.
And so far we've got the basic shape of it. As you can see, we've got the chin, the eyes, part of the nose, and, you know, the jaw part of it, yeah.
Now, Dave, when people are selecting pumpkins, I would assume was yesterday your biggest day? Today, when do you usually get the busiest?
The busiest was last weekend. People would come out and they want to get pumpkins for their decorations for the holidays. Right now it's kind of last minute, if you will.
So do you mark those down? I mean, you don't want a whole bunch of pumpkins that you're not having. What do? Sell them and people make pie out of them or what?
No, well, after today, that's it. They really have no value, to be perfectly honest with you. But we just try and gauge it the best we can and grow as many as possible so everybody gets a good selection. We still have a good selection out there right now.
So I guess you're kind of like the Christmas tree guy on the 25th of December with a whole bunch of Christmas trees. If they're left over, that's that.
Pretty much, yeah. Pretty much. There isn't much value beyond Halloween. They've really become a decoration item only.
Okay. Now, Alan, let's get back. Tell me what you did with this one here. This one, how long did it take you to do this one?
This one took me about 3 hours, and it's a face of a witch.
Well, that's amazing. Now, do you have people at the pumpkin farm who say, I'm going to buy the pumpkin, but I want Alan to do it? Or do you give tips and classes on this, Dave?
Oh, Alan will just give tips and ideas, but unfortunately this year we weren't able to do that. We're looking at doing that next year
okay. For
people to come out.
So where did you get this talent? I mean, is this just something you do with art and it happens to be on pumpkins? You do other things too?
Well, I do other things too. I'm a trained sculptor and fine artist. I went to art school in San Francisco
okay. For
it. And Dave just happened to discover me through internet, through the search engine. And he thought that I would be able to carve pumpkins too.
Okay.
And I airbrush for a living, actually.
So you tell your friends around the holidays you have a little side business where you get into some...
Oh, they already know.
They already
know
that stuff.
Yeah.
What about at Christmas? Do you have a specialty for Christmas?
Yeah, I airbrush on stockings and on T-shirts like this one. I airbrush on T-shirts.
Okay, so you do that too.
Yeah.
All right, outstanding.
And then we do Christmas trees too.
Okay, you can meet Alan in person. It's at Dave's Pumpkin Patch in West Sacramento. For more information, there it is. 3010 Burroughs Avenue in West Sacramento, 916-849-9450. Dave, you open tonight?
We are open tonight. It's a safe place to bring your kids out, go through the corn maze. We're not going to do anything haunted, but we are going to have some candy stations and try and make it fun for the kids.
Okay, we like it. Alan, David, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Dave's Pumpkin Patch in West Sacramento. Well, fog is burning off in the region as we look at more scary people down here getting candy. We've got a lot of folks down here having fun, and we're going to continue this over the next 40 minutes or so. Stay with us. Eileen Javora breaks down the Halloween forecast. That is next.